Okay, good afternoon. I'm Javier from the Rotki team, and here I'm going to talk about our product, our vision. So the outline for this presentation is start talking about what is Rotki, and then we will share our values, how we want to expand our community, and then our vision for the product and for the space. First, the team. We are Rotki, a very small team. We have Kelsos, that is the guy developing the front end. And then is Lesteris, that is the founder. Probably you know him. He has made a lot of things and contributions to the Ethereum Foundation. And then it's me, Javier. I come from Spain. They are both based in Berlin. And I joined recently the team. So this is my first presentation in Rotki. What we are building at Rotki is a portfolio tracker utility that also does accounting for you. And we want to do it in an open source way. It's a local app, so everything is local in your computer. All the information is stored solely on your computer, and you are the only one having access to it. And of course, we are privacy focused, very important in this field. So for the functionalities, here you have a screenshot of how is the portfolio tracking functionality. We allow to track balances from different blockchains, balances in exchanges. Also, you can manually input information into the app, and then we aggregate this information for you. The portfolio tracking functionality is very integrated in the Ethereum blockchain. If you have different addresses, you can import them, and then all your information in the blockchain made public is retrieved for you without needed to you to manually input them. And we query for tokens and balances that you could have. This is not only for Ethereum, but we also do Bitcoin and Kusama Polkadot and many others. For information in different DeFi protocols, we also aggregate it for you, and we have customized views for it. So in the part of accounting, you can retrieve information from your trades, both DeFi trades that you can make, or also including trades in exchanges, and also operation that you would normally do in exchanges like deposit, withdrawal, all kind of information that will be useful for you into the accounting part. Also for different actions that we can currently track, we have the option to manually input this information for you so you can keep track of everything. And then we can, with all this information, you can select to create a report for you, and this will output information like your profit and loss for different inputs, and then your total taxable profit and loss. As I said, the application is very integrated in the Ethereum ecosystem, and we have a very modular approach to it. So for each DeFi protocol, we create a module. And for each one, we have custom views. Like, for example, for Yen, you can see the events that you made, your current deposits in the Yen protocol. For liquidity pools, you can see your amount in the pools and your profit for it. And in the case of trades, you can see the decomposition. If you made several trades inside the same transaction, it's already recorded, so you can properly tax it. And not only that, but Rotki also provides you with information that will be useful for you. Like, for example, if you have maker vaults, you can see information about the vault, like the collateralization ratio. And if you can, you have the possibility to set an alert, so you will receive an email saying, take care of your collateral. Also, we do the same for other protocols, like Liquidity recently created bounty for us to create, integrate them into the app. And also, in the case of airdrops, we do airdrop tracking for many of the popular ones. So if you have any address that had an airdrop, you will be notified in the app. We create then cool statistics, like your total balance are in the all time. And a very cool feature that we have is that you can see how much of each token you had in every account, and then aggregate it in a general view. And for exchanges, the same. You can track every exchange balances in the same way you will do for DeFi. In our roadmap, we have the integration of more EVM compatible chains. That is something that we are working on right now. We also want to interact with the blockchain itself, because right now the app retrieves information from it, but can output information, has output to the blockchain. So this is something that we want to do. Zeta Caching Support is something we are doing right now. Lefter is doing it right now. Decode evidence, events from the Ethereum transactions to properly track everything that is happening on chain, because now we rely on other sources of information to give this information, but we want to do it manually by yourself, and of course adding more protocols and things to the app. And now I want to talk about our values and why we are doing what we are doing. So why open source, why local? And first, the open source part, we like to do everything transparency, with transparency. So you can check every step of development. We have Discord channels with every information is public. The code is in a GitHub repo, and you can access it and verify that what we do is indeed what we tell you we do. Also, this is allowing us to create a great community around the app. And of course, you have the reusability part of creating an open source project. Someone has already made apps on top of the Rotki source code. And this is something beautiful, I believe. And of course, you can contribute. An example of this, we have seen them recently. Like, for example, people from Snowball Protocol, I believe it's called, needed an Avalanche integration, and they went and did it. Like, they integrated the whole C-chain information capturing. And another user needed information from Coinbase that we were not providing, and he went and made the implementation in the backend and the frontend that was needed. So even if we don't provide you certain functionalities, you can go to the code and modify it to do it like you want. Then we have why being a local app, and this is, allows you to be the real owner of your information. When you are the owner of information, you also get privacy, and a good part of the being a local app is that you don't need us to provide a server that has to be up every time, 100% uptime. It's all, everything in your computer, and your computer downloads the information. Nothing is going through our servers. And of course, this can work offline for certain functionalities, like doing accounting. If you don't have a connection to internet, it's possible to use the app. Also, about privacy, recently we have found these terms and conditions for an accounting tool that does something similar to us, and they state publicly that they track you and they will sell your information if needed. And this is something that we care a lot about and we want to share with you. Like, privacy is important for you, should be important for you, and you have to take care of your information. These values also have seen answer in the community. Like, traction in the app has grown significantly recently. Number of downloads has increased a lot. Logins per day, people opening the app has increased a lot. And the contributors, of course, are growing every day. Also, we have received several amounts of money in donations in the Gitcoin runs. Our Discord server is growing every day with new people making requests, or asking for support, or even contributing to discussions. We have many interactions in our social networks. People are recommending Rotki, actually. We see people say, I have used this app to track my balances, and also use you. So this is something beautiful that we have recently seen. And of course, we have received grants from people for communities that needed integration of in our code. And it's not just me saying this, it's also the community. This guy needed an integration with Polkadot and needed better support, and he added more nodes. This user is valuing the privacy inside the app. Here, he's recommending again the app and saying that we are doing it correctly. And the defense of the Web3 vision, we at Rotki try to do real Web3, and this is something that the user really wants. And also, many people is keeping the eyes in our project. Like, recently, we added support for NFT. And someone noticed it in the GitHub repository. And effectively, a few days later, we released the functionality. So we are not just building a product. We are building a community. It's being built at Discord. It's being built at Twitter. We are planning to create Twitter spaces to talk with you guys. sharing thoughts together, and who knows, maybe eventually creating a DAO to incentivize our values, sharing privacy, open source, and everything in our culture publicly and expanding them to other projects. And another thing in our vision is to create open source middleware to abstract everything related to accounts, balances, and analytics that we do already in our app, but should be done in other places in an open source way. And this is a real problem that we have to solve, because many projects duplicate efforts. There are other balance trackers that are doing the same we are doing, and everything is closed source. No one can reuse code. We are all reinventing the wheel. Also, it's impossible to keep up to date. Many protocols released every day, many new functionalities that need to be implemented. And we are, as I saw, a very small team, and it's not something that we can keep up to date. Even bigger teams eventually will run out of money, and they will need more money to continue adding things. Also, there is an increasing barrier. If you wanted to create something similar to what we are doing, you will find that you have to implement a lot of things. You have to take into account several problems that we already faced, and why not share with you? If you want, you can reuse our code if we get to make a middleware and improve your project, even make it better, who knows? And you can contribute to it. And also, DeFi is expanding globally. We have seen this recently. More people are accessing to DeFi, and they need resources to do tracking, accounting, and all these things that we do. And why not create a software that makes this possible? A plugin system that you put your requirements, and then the app is customized for you. And of course, collaboration is a key to solve this problem. We can solve this problem in our own. We need other people, other teams that share our values, that say, hey, we can help with this. We also need this. Let's do this. So a few requirements that should be included in this kind of middleware is it has to be open source. I have mentioned this. Open source is key in this space and is something that is in the core of all the values of Ethereum and other solutions. It needs a good design. It's not something that we want to start and imposing other people. The design should be consensus and should solve problems in a general way. Has to be modular. As I say, if a person from, say, from Spain needs a module for tracking with Spain rules, he could be able to add it to the app and start working with it. Has to be multilingual in the sense that if you add a Go mod, if your code is written in Go and mine is written in Python, it should be possible for me to reuse your code. And also needs to keep up to date. As I said, it's very important in this space that is growing so fast to keep up to date with what is happening and add every protocol that keeps popping up to the source code. And this is something that I said, it's a collaboration that we can do in different projects, but also as individuals, you can go and propose ideas. We have open channels for this in our Discord server. So if you if you like the idea and you want to contribute, hey, pop in into our Discord channel and share your ideas with us. As I said, this is something that is already happening. Konyon, that is a guy very active in our channel, created a tool, Open Rotki, to fulfill these needs, because he needed a special way of providing information, and he created the app over Rotki. So as I said, we are hiring, we are a very small team. So if you are a Python developer or a JavaScript, TypeScript view developer, considering Apply to us if you like what we are doing. And of course, join to our community. You can try the app, has a free tier, and then there is a premium tier for more functionalities. Follow us in Twitter. We are very active there. We share ideas and things. And of course, buy premium if you want to support us. And as I said, we are hiring if you want to contribute. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
I see that we have 3 minutes. If anyone has any question.
Of course. Is there any question in the audience?
Any question or any idea that you want to share?
Okay. Otherwise, you can talk to him later, I think.
Sorry?
Otherwise, they can come to you to talk to you.
Yeah, you can come to me. I will be over the event until the end, hopefully. And if you want to talk or anything, I will be